Hello again, it's Pilot Special. This is the fourth episode now of the Gullwing Airlines New Sky Virtual Airline video series. Today's flight will be from Hartford Bradley International Airport to Toronto Billy Bishop. Billy Bishop is home, obviously, to Porter Airlines and lots of Q400 flying, so it's only appropriate that we also have a route into there. Sea weather in Hartford is pretty dreary and rainy. So let's hop in. Let's take a look at the flight plan. Okay, we got our briefing package here. Not sure why it's not centered on the screen. There we go. So let's run through this. All right. We're flight 105, ship 102, which is 450 Golf Whiskey. Bradley to Toronto, Billy Bishop. Estimated time en route, 1 hour 13 minutes, 17:25 Zulu, and expecting to arrive at 18:45 Zulu. Elevation, Billy Bishop's 252 feet. It's not a huge elevation change. We have flight level 240. Winds out of the west, so have a bit of a headwind. So our true airspeed 326. 63 passengers, 4,800 pounds of cargo. Takeoff gross weight 61,258. Okay. Bradley directs CTR, direct CAM, direct Syracuse, direct Dines, direct to Billy Bishop. Okay, let's take a look at the NOTAMs. Airport NOTAMs. Wet. It's faded. Two, four, five, five, five. 100% wet. I think we're departing 1-5. Just looking before I started the video, I think we're going to be a little weight limited on 1-5, so we'll take a look again before we get the final numbers. Coastal 9. So there's no, we're going to be on VATSIM, but there's no controllers on, so usually we'll get the Bradley 6 out of Bradley. Dry. I don't know if she's not recommended. Okay, we have some approach minima changes. Keep one of those, and we'll brief those again when we go for arrival. Right. Weather. Okay, takeoff option is not required. Destination TAF. Two 0 10. Greater than 6 statues was really broken in 2500. So if we do have to go runway 6, it would be the end of the world. Since that measure was scattered at 5,000, broken at 1,400. Sorry, scattered at 500, broken at 1,400, overcast at 4,200. So those are some low-level clouds. Have to keep note of. Okay. So that's our OFB. Let's go take a look at our weather briefing. Or sorry, the graph forecast. So as you can see, Bradley is showing IFR condition, or sorry, marginal VFR conditions. METAR showing 2204, condition miles 900, broken 1400. It's precipitation. So there was a big cell that moved through. Looks like there's a convective signet off to the east. That shouldn't be a factor for us since we're heading westbound. Might be a few little cells and dodge on the way out here. Other than that, it looks pretty good. Things look mostly VFR out further west. Definitely expect some icing on the way out. Let's see. Yeah, 15,000. We're gonna get some icing. Take note of that. Okay, I think we've briefed our flight. Let's get aboard. Let's get the plane set up. Let's start getting the passengers on board. Okay, step in the flight deck. We're gonna do our pre-flight safety check. So start on the overhead. Make sure everything is off or should be. I was vertical. The switches are off. Lights are off. Gears off. Ignitions off. Lights are off. Off. 12 o'clock. Please do. Minning off. Okay, coming down. Gear lever's down. Parking brake is on. Dust lock's on. Throttles are in disc. And condition levers are cut off. It's off. Alright, looks good. Do have ground power already connected, so let's get it. Batteries on. Screens up, check batteries, they're discharging, voltages on the central main buses look good, so we'll go ahead and get external power on, and we're showing a charge on all the batteries, and secondary buses on, okay? We'll go through our receiving flows now, generator's on, main bus ties tie, external power's on, ice protection is all off, it's all off again, running lights, it's everywhere. Data recorder to ground test. Off. And so we can fire test. Okay. Engine one. Engine two. And this test really, one thing that's missing here is you should be showing these valves going forward when they shut. But, updated in a future version. And baggage compartment and forward baggage compartment. Dome lights don't need to go on. Keep our panel lights on. APU will move off for now. Navigation's going to warm. Set switch is centered. Forward alpha valve's closed. Blue switch to auto. And our landing altitude is going to be 250 feet. Exterior lights on. Your recirc fan is on. Cabin temps are blue. Both of them smoking. Caution panel. And our advisory lights, make sure all those light up. Looks like it is. Okay, make sure those are bright. Okay, now we got extra power from now, so you start getting the plane fueled. I already have the fuel load in here, our passenger load, so I get power to the airplane so we can start fueling. So that's going to be going on. And now we can continue with the rest of the receive checks. I'll go here, I'll check circuit breakers. Documentation's on board, oxygen masks, your gear pins, smoke hood, torches, and crash axe, and fire extinguisher, fire gloves, and smoke goggles. Your takeoff warning test one. And I did computer one. Terrain. Okay, across the airship. spoiler switch to taxi. He switches it both out.
Mine's slow.
To be a missed test.
Pull up. Pull up. Pass. Good there. Rear panel will fill in our default squat code and then expand. Make sure TARA and do our TCAS test, which isn't going to work. I'll also come here, get our ATIS.
Temperature 20, dew point 18, altimeter 2994, arriving runway 0615, departing runway 0615, advise on initial contact you have, information, Quebec.
Quebec's current.
Bradley, information, Quebec, 1710, Zulu, special, wind, light, and variable, visibility 7 miles, rain, sky conditions, broken at 950. Broken at 2,400. Overcast at 4,500. Temperature 20. Dew point 18. Altimeter 2994. Arriving runway 0615. Departing runway.
Alright, so it is kind of rainy and marginal VFR conditions, but the reason we don't need to take off alternate here is we do have instrument approaches that will get us down below that 900 foot broken level, so we're going to be good on that account. We have two precision approaches into the Bradley Airport. Alright, I'm going to go get our route plan, and then we'll start looking at our performance. So we have options for runway 6 and runway 15 available. Probably end up going out runway 6 just because it's longer. They'll eliminate the need for any weight restriction that we have. I like going out on 3-3 because that's closest to the terminal, but again, 33 is not in use, so let's go flight plan. Let's see. Just check to make sure this is current. Drift, TR can, I'm assuming, start dying.
looks good to me. So we're playing for number 6. Bradley 6. Did that. Bishop showing 280. So and their longer runway is get this in ahead of time. Say we're taking your half for now, and we get that figured out once we're in the air. Okay, let's get our fuel set up. So we'll come back to Foxit. Zero fuel weight is 55,695. Fuel on board at 6,000 pounds. Our alternate. Gross weight 61,695. So let's go before I do that. Let's get a full number in here. Okay, now let's go to our performance fast airplane toolbox. And let's check out our performance here. So Brad has a 1.5. So at 1.5 we're saying 67.90 is our max, which is 61.695. So it looks like we are going to have to go to runway 6. Check that. Get it again. So that'll work. Flaps 5 departure. 90% torque. And 61.695. Yeah, that'll still work. Alright, so runway 6 will work for us. Let's get our V speeds in here. Same. Okay. So we're still loading everything. Top altitude. Bradley 6. So, triple D. Oh, now we're going to turn 6. They don't have. Oh, not 9 G 3. 15 G. Alright, so maybe we're out of date on those, but that's the latest that we have. Okay, these are not from the world, so that's okay. So, if you just have the tender, you're required. Take up minimum solar ground speed, be about 152 knots. So, 1100 feet per minute, that should be plenty. 6 standard takeoff minimums. Okay, we're going to Chester VOR. So, the initial climb from 6.075 was assigned. And our top altitude would be 4,000 feet. Okay. Mountain cell. So we'll stay in wings level. And then we'll go ahead and select the 400 feet, turn 075, and then get our radar vectors to Chester VOR. Okay. Alright, all passengers aboard, we're still blowing the bags, so let's go ahead. The plane's all set up, let's go through our pre-flight checklist, and then we'll do our departure briefing and PA for passengers. Alright, main bus tie is tied, battery temp and charge below 0.1, we're good, battery voltage is greater than 24, engine intake doors are green, circuit breakers have been checked, they're in. Alternate gear door and inhibit switch are shut, hatch is shut. Fire and smoke detection has been tested. Bleeds 1 and 2 are off. AP bleed is off. Recirc fan is on. Pressurization ready for the elevation set. Auto and forward off low knobs closed. Auto feather has been tested. Emergency lights are on. Fuel quantity 6,000 pounds. Check parking brake pressure above 500 psi. Nose wheel steering is off. The FMS is set. Right, takeoff briefing. Expect gross weight 61695. We'll be departing runway 7. Still haven't figured out how to keep everything organized on the screen yet. But I apologize for that. Alright, back to the departure briefing. So gross weight 61695. We'll be departing runway 6, 9,510 feet available. Expect the taxi route to be coming out Sierra and then Charlie 1. We'll have the full length of the runway available. It's BA flaps 5 and top takeoff. RV speeds are 128, 128, 131, 141, and 153. Departure will be the Bradley 6. We'll have fly 075, or as assigned. Top altitude would be 4,000 feet, no other restrictions. Expect radar vectors to Chester VOR. So we'll get the Chester VOR here. 1151. And we'll get our bearing pointer. VOR 1. Okay, Chester VOR. Get out of flight mode for takeoff. Be wings level, then we'll go to heading at 400 feet. And we'll climb and go around until 1,000 feet, and then we'll accelerate to 210 knots. Anti-icing, we will expect some icing on the climb out. Looks like the worst icing level is around 15,000 feet, but no anti-icing will be required for departure. And we'll have a bleeds on takeoff. Abort procedure, below 80 knots, we're stopping for any master caution or warning. We'll stop on the necessary exit if able and cancel the caution and deal with the problem. Above 80 knots, we're only stopping for fire, failure, fear, or wind shear.
The Ventimin engine out. Continue to fly the SID. The MSA is 3,100 feet to the east. So we'll climb on runway heading to 3,100 feet and expect vectors back in. Minimum weather is above marginal VFR. So we'll be looking at instrument approach back into the runway. Probably come back in on runway 6. Okay, threats. It is a wet runway. So braking action, if we have to abort, might be less than ideal, especially with this airplane. Braking action is less than ideal to begin with. Any questions? Okay. Alright, looks like we're finishing up loading the bags. And we should be ready to go. Let's get our PA. Folks, welcome aboard Gulling Airlines Flight 105, service to Toronto Billy Bishop. Our flight time today will be about an hour and 13 minutes. Cruise altitude will be 24,000 feet. Might have a little bit of weather on the departure here, but once you get to cruise altitude, it should be pretty smooth. So sit back, relax, and enjoy our dash 8 marker. Alright, looks like we're all buttoned up. So let's run over those numbers one more time. Zero fuel weight is 54,573. 6,000 pounds on board. Gross weight 65,73. A little bit lighter.
Great news, Captain. Your tow's coming.
So that is going to change. We're also, I think we didn't account for the wet runway before, so that's going to drop down our V1 speed. New V1 is 109, 17, 20, 32, 52. Flaps at 10 departure. Alright. Let's go through that one more time. We're at flaps 10 departure, end top 90%. V1 109, 117, 121.
Alright. Looks like the doors and hatches are closed 52. And we're ready to connect.
Okay. Four starting engines trim. 1, 2, 3 set. Spoilers to taxi. Door lights are out.
We got that winching strap and adapter hooked up. Go ahead and let go of the parking brake when you're ready for a push.
Passenger signs are on. Cabin ports and receive flight deck door is locked. Anti-collision lights are on. APU bleed is off. Disconnect the GPU. And our battery starting volts are good. Okay, ready for push. Brake off.
with the pushback.
Hey, Captain, let me know where you want this thing.
And tell him where I wanted to go.
Here comes the pushback. Light him up.
All right. Day of start number one first. Switch number one, select. Man H. Star feather. And fuel flow. Low pressure's coming up. ITT's rising. Select an H. Start fighting. Fuel flow.
Just about done here. Go ahead and set your parking brake.
Okay, parking brake set.
And we're disconnecting the tow. Give me just a moment. And we're disconnected. Signal and pin on the left. Take it easy and have a safe flight.
I don't have a signal pin yet. Okay, once he's clear, we'll go to 1020 RPM. And we'll do our F-star flows. Okay. This time. Off, fuse tabs. Above 20 C's, heat. Leads on the mid. Those rules don't go on. So, flaps 10. Some hydraulic, BTU. And hydraulic number 3, check your elevator. Static 1-2 standby on the transponder TAR. name before taxi check. Again, knows what steering is on. Passenger briefing is in progress. Rail services are secured. Taxi clearance brief has been received. Brake check. Okay. Brakes work. Takeoff warning. Okay. Gust lock off. Auto flight control modes makes all go around. Also armed. And turn the yaw damper on. And then once we're clear the ramp, go taxi light.
Station now.
Checklist gear up, flaps 0,
Climb power set, so the hydraulic speeds are off, fuel pumps are off, and all the feather is off. It's pretty accurate to what gets depicted in sim. So we'll keep this in the background. Interesting cloud formations we got.
because of the turbulence here, once we hit 15,000 feet, we're going pitch roll. And we're not constantly fighting to keep that airspeed.
Alright, so I'm looking at the approaches into Billy Bishop. So, runway 26, we have a localizer approach. And then there's two RNAVs. Localizer, pretty straightforward. Might end up doing that. I've got to run the RNAV a bunch. This gets down to 720 feet. The RNAV X-ray, so this gets us down a little at 572. This one will require special authorization. So this, I'm guessing this is probably what Porter uses, what they developed. This is more straight in for 26. And then the RNAV Zulu. Let's see, you get to your approach point at Ebb Gap, and then kind of making a turn into the runway. So, this one also, we have a do not exceed 140 knots on the missed approach. Which that might be might be a little tough for us. We'll probably be right at like a 140 to bother. So I think we're gonna do the RNAV X-ray. We're gonna assume our carrier is also approved for the same procedure, and we're gonna, I believe that's what we're gonna have set up in here. Yeah, we're gonna X-ray, and optics. 5 miles from our top of descent. So just want to review our arrival and approach briefing. So there's no star for this route. We're going to be descending directly to Omtex after Dines. Top descent's a little bit after Dines. We'll be on the RNAV X-ray from runway 26. Final course 265 degrees. Incision altitude is 572 feet. Airport elevation 252 feet, which should have no landing altitude. This procedure, climb 800 feet on track 265 and climb a left turn 2000 direct to use it. MSA is 3100 feet. So this is restricted instrument procedure. We're going to discuss that. We're assuming that our airline is approved to use this procedure. That allows to do the straight in for 26. So we're going to go direct Omtex. From Omtex, above 2000 to Verbi. Verbi to Oval, final approach, fix, and then down to Amid. Threshold crossing height is 58 feet. Minimum is 572. And methane angle is 3.98 degrees. So it's a little steeper than our typical approach. So we're going to be, we have flaps 35 landing. Coming into Firefox, and our landing performance. So this isn't giving me any good numbers for our expected landing weight. As you can see here, 57.5, so this will probably be around 57,000 pounds, but based on the runway length, it's not. No landing days were found because of the runway maximum landing limit. So there must be some special compensation for the quarter. Q400 is coming into here. Let's see, is there anything here? Talks about that. So that's what we're seeing line. We just had that one, so we're going to glide path. Okay, nothing about maximum. Let's go to the airport. Not anything specific. At the weather. Out to Canada, so maybe that's not a good place.
back to it. So because we're not getting landing speeds, we're going to use the landing speed card. So we're going to be 57,000 pounds. It's going to be roughly 26,000 kilograms. So it's a VRF 116. And we're going to be at 36. Okay. Coming up on top of the ascent. Since we all want to continue to approach, we can wind this down all the way to our minimums. So and then this should automatically have the approach and bring us right down to normal. Okay. Send check was complete.
Okay, in terms of parking threats, so we're going to come in. Probably going to have to go all the way down to Alpha. So we'll come in Alpha and then we'll pull in one of these gates right here. It doesn't really matter which gate we're going to. Whatever's easiest for us. So come down Alpha and come down this way. Doubt we're going to be able to stop in time to get off on Echo. Threats, we do have a very, very short runway. A steep approach, so we'll be maximum reverse thrust, and we've got to be aware that sometimes with the throttle setup I have, the reverse thrust ski doesn't engage on both engines at the same time, so we may have a little bit of yawing action there, so we'll just keep a heads up for that. Okay, coming down to 18,000, get our altimeter set. Also gonna back us up with the localizer for 2.6. Actually, you know what? We're not gonna do that because the localizer for 2.6 may not be aligned with the RNAV. That's just be unnecessary. We should be able to see the runway just fine. contact, so he'll lose 10 knots. Coming through 10,000 feet, their approach light's on, their orbital light on. Tenor set 2999er, 0.16, and we'll get our fuel transfer stop, fuel pumps on, and then standby hydraulics and PTU, and bleeds on. So 8 miles to move where we want to be, at least 180 knots, flaps 5, and then 160 knots, flaps 15. You also have to remember flaps 35, 158. So if we're 160 knots by 6 miles, we go flaps 35. Because of the short runway as well, you're not doing a near 10 P approach if we do need to go around to the full 10 P landing. Get to flat side just to lower our deck angle a little bit because it's a steeper approach. We're already at idle, so that's allowed us to keep a little bit more power. Mute. skyline ahead of us, and there's a runway. Galaxy Taxi. Kill us, yeah, and we're going through the fuel truck. Starfeather. Yeah. Start the chrono for 30 seconds. And once that engine's off. Seconds. Engine 2 is off. Emergency lights off. Taxi lights off. Easy mission off.
hopefully, looks like I fixed my problems with New Sky. I had to reinstall my IPv4 drivers, but let's see what we got. 9.82, average session 1.37 G's, 5.4 feet per minute, distance from threshold 233 meters, average standard deviation 0.91, max standard deviation 2.25. All right, so it seems like everything was perfect except for our standard deviation. Let's show. So here's the report. So it looks like it may not all fit in the window, but 9.82 is our score. Looks like we're just a little firm on the landing, but again, That's what you want. A little short, not too terrible. Again, short runway, it's better than being long. So, yeah, pretty good flight there. All right, that's it. Thanks again for watching. Looks like there's a few people that are watching these videos, so hope you enjoy them, and look forward to making more. See ya.